will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here to take you.
Bless the Lord and welcome to another exciting day on the Voice of Resurrection. I have to move up. Hallelujah. We thank God for you, beloved. We've been ministering the path of consecration into the power of God. We showed at the beginning of this week, beloved, that everything that God will do in our lives this year will happen through His power. And the way the power of God comes is obeying the Lord, consecrating to His instructions, consecrating from anything that will cause a blockade, you know, on our path, receiving the power of the Holy Spirit upon us. We know that we receive the Holy Spirit as salvation. He's in us. As we die to the flesh, then the power grows in us. But for us to get things done, the power must be upon us. I'll pour you a blessing that will come upon you. Excuse me. See, and so for that to happen, we must relinquish our wounds, our hurts, our disappointments, our own visions. Particularly, this one is the biggest, the lust of vindication. You want God to show them. You want God to bless you so you can feel that you've gotten paid for your suffering. God promises all those things, but not when we demand them, you see, because we don't tell God. Everything is by His grace. Everything is His favor. Everything is His mercy. It may be a greater level of understanding I haven't attained yet. But I know He says, concerning my word, command ye me. But the blessing is that all that I am is by the grace of God. All that God will get done is by His grace. And I want you to come through that path so that you will not fall into the snare of Satan. Listen to the word of God. The disciples are grappling with this thing, this prejudice issue, this racism issue, this Roman occupation issue. They said, Lord, will thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? He said unto them, it's not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in His own power. The Father does whatever He wants on the earth. No man can challenge Him. Many times things may not go the way you like in your life, but you have to serve God through it. Sometimes God will show you that it's really your own engineering based on some disobedience or error or whatever that caused that to happen. You have to come to grips with these realities. So God will help tenderize your heart and keep you in the place where you can receive your miracles more readily. It's not for you, He says, to know the times or the seasons which the Father had put in His own power. When He's ready, He'll get it done. But you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. You know this? The Holy Ghost comes upon us, and then the power comes behind Him. The power, Holy Spirit is the avenue to God's power. He is the third person of the Trinity, and Trinity is not written in the Scriptures, but we know God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, all right? So the Holy Spirit has already come upon us, and now we need the power to manifest through our lives. He says, and you shall be witnesses. What is the purpose of it? You shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. You notice, God had a global agenda and a global vision for His children, but they were still mired in the issues of prejudice and racism and who is ruling what and who has what money and who is controlling what. No, beloved, He had something greater, something mightier, not only on the earth, but eternally. Even if the Lord drove away the Romans, nothing said that their disciples would get any positions. Because the world can never love you if you know the Lord. The world can never accept you. Even fellow believers who are not hearing from the Lord, who don't understand what the Lord is doing in your life, will not accept you or approve of what you're doing. That's my experience. But I am sure that everything I'm doing, is from God. God ordained it, and God is certifying it, and God is favoring it, and God is helping us do it. I pray that that same grace will be upon you, that that same miracle will work in your life, so you can see the power of God made manifest in this season of grace in the mighty name of Jesus. Can you imagine that the Lord's agenda for these people was that they would become apostles right there in Jerusalem, then they will take it in the neighboring Judea and Samaria, and then globally. Wow! How can I have such a global assignment, global destiny? And I am preoccupied with Mickey Mouse issues. That's why you consecrate your pain, consecrate your doubts, consecrate, in other words, put them on the altar and give it to God. Let Him have it, so that you can enter into what He has for you. Fly the plane when you don't have food to eat, you see. Believe for a jet when you know you can't afford it. I just went through that for 4 years. I was trying to get this propeller plane, and I decreed that they wouldn't sell it. The poor people have held it. This thing's been there now for 6 years or longer. Then they started flying it until they've almost flown out the engines. So now it has to be redone. Because there was an impasse. Every time I prayed, I was getting a jet, but my financial realities doesn't accommodate such things. I didn't know that that was the hindrance. I mean, if you don't consecrate these things, they blind you. Do you know that in 2010, God made my leaders give me a beautiful crystal rendition of a Learjet? Or it could be a Citation, whatever. And I received it, but still didn't see the vision. My mind was still stuck on that propeller, because I was sizing up my finances. If you don't consecrate what you think and what you feel and how you see it, and embrace the vision He's giving you, the power of the Holy Spirit will not come forth. It will not manifest to give you the inheritance the Lord has already promised. Beloved, this is a down-to-earth message. This is something that you must face in your own life. If God is talking to you about a healing ministry and you're sick, start in healing. Start preparing yourself. Get ready for the day He will tap on you and you start moving. You see? That's why I encourage everyone to keep going. You're hurting, keep going. You don't know when the Lord will say, okay, that's enough. You don't know even what brought about what you're going through. And then He will sign off on it. But in pain, serve God. In frustration, serve God. Wherever you are, serve God. You'll see that your destiny is greater than your mind had ever imagined. Beloved, we love you. Receive these words. May it change your life and give you a destiny among them that are sanctified. May you experience the power of God in consecration in 2015. May the Lord bless you. We love you. We'll see you next week. Apostle, bye-bye. The Lord is waiting on you. Yes, He is.